Now guys, have you recently just downloaded iOS 18 Apple CarPlay, but are experiencing some issues? It seems that some of you are. Although it is quite rare and I myself haven't had any issues, I thought I'd make a video about it. So here's some troubleshooting steps that you guys can take to hopefully get it back up and running again. Let's take a look. So first things first, and guys, please make sure that you follow the steps that I'm showing in this video one by one in the order that I'm showing you. You may have already tried steps 1, 2, or 3 and that sort of thing, but the ones toward the end of the video are a little bit more complicated in kind of this troubleshooting process. So bear with me for the first few steps. So first things first, and guys, and I'm just gonna state the literal obvious here. Make sure your car actually does have Apple CarPlay. I know that sounds really, really silly, but just in case you've jumped in, for example, a new car, you've got a loan car, I don't know, you just assume the car has CarPlay, just triple check to make sure that the car has CarPlay before we go any further. However, it does make a difference if you are using it wired or wireless. So we'll start with wired first. Make sure you're using the correct cable. Not all USB-C cables and lightning cables are the same, rather annoyingly. Some only do provide power, and I've seen this countless times before where people assume that it should be working because it's charging the phone, for example, but the wrong cable's being used. So make sure that the cable does work. Say, for example, this one here isn't like an official cable, but it's like a kind of braided cable. I know this works, but some just don't. So just double check that. So either one that comes in the Apple box when you pick up your phone, for example, one you've got at home, just try another cable in case you're not sure. Also as well, on the cable front, if you're using a USB-C to USB dongle, just in case you aren't in the kind of world of USB-C yet, make sure the dongle works as well. Again, some of these only provide power. I use these ones called Syntec when I do a conversion to USB-C, although having said that, a lot of things are USB-C in my life now, which is great, one cable for everything, but just double check, it could be this as well. So yes, double check a few cables and obviously make sure you're using it in the correct USB-C port or USB port, depending on the car. In this one, you can actually use it in any of them, but I know some only allow you to use it in this one over here. So just double check that with the car manufacturer. So after we covered all the cable front, now we can test the car. Now, the best thing to do with this is to, forgive me, turn it off and turn it back on. That does fix quite a few things. So if you've been on a long road trip before, I've had a multimedia system just stop working with CarPlay before on my previous car, and turn it off, turn it back on, and it's working again. Now, you might not be able to do this while driving, so sometimes you might need to actually just stop the car, turn it off for a few minutes, and then turn it back on, because cars are quite complex these days. But there is a way you can do it in this particular car. Sometimes it's like a soft reset, so certainly Volkswagens, if you hold the power button for about, I think it's about 7-8 seconds, that will kind of soft reset the car. It's basically just a reboot, so to speak. Same with this one, if you hold the volume button, just keep holding it in and eventually it'll just turn off and reboot. Believe it or not, sometimes it can be as simple as that. Now this next one is to make sure that Siri or Hey Siri is actually enabled on your phone. No, it didn't trigger, luckily. I know how sensitive they are sometimes, and sorry if I've just triggered it on your own phones at home. But no, make sure it is actually enabled, because it's so heavily used on Apple CarPlay. Apple CarPlay will not launch if Siri is not enabled, for example. So on your phone, go to settings, then go down to Siri or Apple Intelligence if you're lucky enough to be on that one yet. And then just make sure that voice assistant is enabled, because if it's off, CarPlay just simply will not launch. Another thing to try after this is to simply turn your phone off and turn it back on. I know this sounds really, really simple, but I have done this to someone before who had a problem with Apple CarPlay and suggested it as well online, and it's fixed it. No idea why, but again, the simple turn off and turn back on the phone can sometimes help. Another really, really small thing as well is, while we're on that topic, is just make sure that if you are plugging it in via the cable, is that your case isn't preventing it from being plugged in properly. Because yeah, it can sometimes be as something as simple as that. I have seen that once before as well. And then if that doesn't work, now we move on to some more troubleshooting steps, and these are things that you might not have tested. So the next thing to try is to delete your car from your phone and delete your phone from the car. So you're going to unpair it on both sides, just the Bluetooth and the CarPlay kind of elements. So on your phone, go to settings, then go to Bluetooth, find your car in this list, tap on the little blue eye, and then forget this device, and then forget device in red. While you're there as well, go back in settings, go to general, and then find CarPlay, find your car in this list here, tap on the car, and then forget this car. So you're basically removing that pairing completely from the phone. Now once you've done that, then we need to turn our attention to the car and remove it on there as well. Now guys, if one of these has helped you out, please do let me know in the comment section down below. And also, if you're loving the video, make sure to hit that subscribe button. It will help me out massively. Anyway, on with the video. Now there are lots of different car manufacturers out there with various different multimedia systems, so there'll be some form of Bluetooth device manager or previously listed CarPlay devices, so you just want to go in here and delete your phone in that list. This will vary. In my car, it's literally in phone, and then go to the Bluetooth device manager on the bottom there with the kind of Bluetooth symbol. And then you can see all the devices that you've previously connected, you know, ever since you've had the car. For me, you tap on the menu on the right there and then delete device and yes. So that's now deleted from the car. And then we can connect it back up again and hopefully it'll work. Now, I have also heard from multiple places online, primarily in YouTube comments and on TikTok as well, that a few people have experienced a few issues with using a VPN, for example. That's a virtual private network with CarPlay. Now, I personally don't use a VPN service at all. I know that some people do to watch different kind of shows and TV movies and things like that in different countries. But I have heard that it can affect CarPlay. So if you do know what a VPN is, go into your settings and turn that off and try CarPlay then. That could be something that's interfering with it. Apple may have fixed that, but I'm just throwing it out there because a few of you have mentioned that turning off VPN did fix it for you. So if CarPlay is still not working or you're experiencing some kind of weird things or bugs and that sort of thing, what I'd recommend now is to do these next steps, but these require just a little bit more kind of setup afterwards. So they're a little bit more advanced. So this next one I'd recommend is to reset the car's multimedia system. Now, the reason why I say this is a little bit more advanced, because modern cars these days are full of gadgets and they are, you know, getting quite well integrated with our lives. So if you've set up like music streaming services or your sat nav destinations or your radio presets, or generally all the other car settings that you can do, you will probably need to set them all back up again after this step. So little word of caution, just spend a bit of time after this reset to set the car back up again. Otherwise it might annoy you over the next week because you'll find all the default settings are kind of back to the way they were before. One final note before we do this, some car manufacturers, when you reset the multimedia system, will remove it off your app if you're lucky enough to have like a modern car where you can lock and unlock it and do all sorts of things. This car, this Mercedes, doesn't do that handily. It just resets the multimedia system. But I think maybe with Volkswagen, if you reset the multimedia system, it will remove it off the app. So just double check with them first. So to reset this one, on the home screen, go all the way across to settings. So that's usually on the far right hand side. Go in there, then go into system, then go all the way down the page to reset, go in here, tap on reset, then tap yes, and usually there's another prompt after that. Now I'm not going to do this because CarPlay is actually working for me and it's been absolutely fine, and also I don't want to set my car back up again because that will take me like maybe 10-15 minutes, but yeah, I'd rather not. But yeah, if you do need to reset it, try that. Once that's booted back up, try and connect it back up again and hopefully it's working. If that's not working, we're going to now turn your attention to the phone and reset some things on there. So this is known as reset network settings. Now this is quite well hidden. You might not actually know where this one is and may have never touched it before. But I have recommended this to a few people in YouTube comments and social platforms, Instagram, that sort of thing. The reason why I put this further down the list is because when you do this, it does actually wipe all of your home Wi-Fi networks that you've connected to. So if you have your home Wi-Fi at home, you'll need to reconnect back up to your router. Same for work as well, and same for any friends, family, hotspots, that sort of thing in the car. So yeah, you're basically just starting again from Wi-Fi. Weirdly, this does reset a few Apple CarPlay protocols, I think, or something like that, but it has fixed CarPlay issues before. A few of you have asked me in the comment sections before, I've recommended this and it has fixed it. So this is how you do it. On your phone, go to settings, then go down to general, then go down the page to transfer or reset phone. In here, go on reset, and then look at reset network settings. Go in here, pop in your passcode, and then reset it here. Normally your phone will then reboot and then try CarPlay after that, but just remember to connect to all those Wi-Fi networks which will have been erased. If after all of that it's still not working, the only thing I can then suggest is start trying some other devices. So if you have any friends or family, try plugging in their phone into the car, or try your phone in another car, that sort of thing, just to kind of narrow down what it is. If you are still convinced that it is definitely your phone and it isn't working, you know, wired or wireless with CarPlay, depending on the car, the only thing I can suggest then is the last resort, and this one is at the bottom of the list for a reason, and that is to factory reset your phone. This will require a lot of effort, even with a backup. When I literally just set up this phone that I bought recently, it took me like an hour plus just to sign into all the apps again. So yeah, it's down at the kind of bottom of the list for a reason, just because it takes a long time to set everything back up. So before doing this, you should have an iCloud backup, at least I hope you do. If not, please get one, because our phones are very complicated these days and having a backup is like very, very important. But go on to settings, tap on your name, go to iCloud, then scroll down the page here and look for iCloud backup. Just make sure you go in here and make sure, you know, a backup is fairly recent. Make sure backup this phone is, you know, ticked as well. I have this on by default religiously, just because, you know, our phones are so important these days. But yeah, hopefully it doesn't resort to this last one, resetting your phone. But yeah, it might fix it just in case none of the above steps have, you know, resolved the Apple CarPlay issue that you guys might have had. So guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video and hopefully Apple CarPlay is now working for you, because I've had loads of messages over the years of people asking about CarPlay tips and tricks and troubleshooting things when it's not working. So hopefully something in this video has got it working for you. Now, if there are any other tips that you guys have on CarPlay, please pop them in the comment section down below. I might even pin another comment on the comment section if I've forgotten one, but these are kind of the ones I've recommended over the years. And likewise, guys, if you have any suggestions for future videos, let me know in the comment section down below. I'll try and reply to you all. Thanks so much for watching. Until next time, see you then.